was the shadiest place that I've ever seen in my life. Now this is where it gets really, really crazy. Right? Let's go skinny dipping. And it was 0 degrees. I mean, a detailed spreadsheet of every single girl that he had ever. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. So for today's video, I thought it will be fun to do a little travel story time. And I'm going to be talking about a trip that I took during college. It was a really fun trip with a lot of crazy things happening, including creepy guys, shady hostels, freezing waterfalls in the middle of nowhere, and snowfall, and so much more. So I really hope you enjoy this story. Okay, let me give some context here. I went with two of my girlfriends from college to McLeodganj. And it was a really last minute trip. I don't know, we had a weekend off or something and the three of us decided ki chalo, let's go to McLeodganj. So we take the bus and it's an overnight bus. It's not the most comfortable, obviously. Early in the morning, we reach Dharamshala. So now we get off the bus and we look it up on Google Maps and we find that our hostel was just about 10-15 minutes away. So we thought we'll just walk. So we walk down, I think, at least 200 steps and we go down. And then there are tiny, tiny alleyways, but we keep walking. We're thinking, okay, we have this picture in our mind that the hostel is going to be like this. And when we finally reach, it was literally in the middle of nowhere. There wasn't even a board on the hostel. We had to ask somebody and they tell us, oh, this building right there is your hostel. So we think, okay, let's give it a chance. We can go in and we see. So we go in. And it was the shadiest place that I've ever seen in my life. But anyway, we think, okay, we've come so far, let's just go up to our rooms and then we can look for another place for tonight or the next night. So we go up and we go into our room and I'm not even kidding. It was the dirtiest place in the world. It seemed like the sheets had never been washed. The hostel guys were really, really creepy. And to top it off, the door wouldn't lock. Very soon we just realized we can't stay here and we were anyway planning on doing the Triun trek, so we thought okay, we might as well just do it today and we'll spend the night on top of the Triun hill and then come back and stay in Zostel the next day. So we go up. It was, I think it took us around 6 to 8 hours. It was a very scenic trail and some parts of it were tough, but as far as treks go, I think it was easy to maybe moderate in some places, but we were really struggling. Anyway, so we go up. By the time we reach, the sun is just setting and it's beautiful. Then night comes and that's when we realize there's no electricity, there's no washrooms and there's no network. But anyway, all of us just sat around the bonfire at night. We had rajma chawal and brandy and it was really nice. And then I think around 10 p.m. everybody was really tired, so we went back to our tents. Now imagine this, the tent was really, really small. It was actually pretty small for the three of us. And I think it had a hole somewhere because even though we were inside the tent, it felt like we were outside because it was so windy and so cold. It was freezing cold and we didn't even know what the temperature was. So, and now this might be a little TMI, but then one of my friends had a UTI that night. And she was in a lot of pain and the lack of washrooms and the cold was doing nothing to help that. So we wake up the next morning and the minute we come out, it was the most beautiful thing ever. It was a really, really crisp morning. It had snowed a little. So when we got up, there were patches of white snow, fresh snow everywhere. Then unfortunately, the weather was really bad and there was a snowstorm coming. So all of us had to rush back down. So anyway, even then it was really beautiful and at least we got to see the snow on top. But so we climbed down, we walk up to the hostel and it was like a dream, this place, honestly. So it was everything that we had hoped for and a lot more, and especially considering that we'd spent one night in the bus and then one night in that tent without any washrooms and electricity. Just having a clean place with normal amenities was really, really amazing for us. This night, the atmosphere was really, really lively and amazing. There were people from all over the world and we were all talking about our travel stories and having amazing hot chocolate. I can actually still taste that hot chocolate. So now we're all sitting and it's really nice. Somebody's singing, we're drinking a little, and as the night goes on, everybody's getting a little high and everybody's built a really nice rapport and it's really fun. When all of a sudden, and I'm not kidding, this one guy who looked like a really decent guy. Okay, he had his laptop and everything, and he was just focused on his work. He wasn't really engaging in the conversation that much up until this point. He randomly turns his laptop around and pulls up this spreadsheet. I mean, a detailed spreadsheet of every single girl that he had ever approached. And he's talking about how he had approached her and what was her reaction, how beautiful the girl looked, and then what he could do better, and whether he went to first base, second base. So it was like an entire directory of every single girl that he had ever been with or tried to be with. It was really, really weird. So at that point in time, we're all getting a little creeped out and we're trying to phase him out of the conversation. We were like, Now this is where it gets really, really crazy. There was one more guy who was sitting with us, and this guy also had a similar list, a handwritten list, not a spreadsheet this time, but he also had a journal of every single girl that he had ever tried to approach. And it was so objective, as in, okay, so this girl was a 8 on 10, and then I did this, and then she did this, and this is how far I got with her. So my friends and I, we just run back to our room, and then we were really weirded out by then. So we come back, we're laughing, and then we finally fall asleep. So now the next day when we wake up, this is our last day in Dharamkot, after which we are supposed to take the night bus again back to Delhi. So we ask the guy at the hostel counter, and we ask him what we should do that day. He tells us that there was a waterfall to go, and it's really pretty. All right, so all of us start walking. So he's just given us a general direction. You turn this way and you keep going straight. So we reach a point where there is nothing. So we are walking here. This is where the road ends, and then there's a ledge which was this wide, and if you look down, it went right into a cliff, and then after that it went onto a rocky stream, and then we couldn't see anything. So all of us, we somehow, I'm actually surprised none of us got hurt or died that day. We finally reached this place, and it was the most amazing hidden waterfall. So it was like a stream coming directly from the white snow-capped mountain tops, and it was coming down, and there were pools of water everywhere. So we're just looking at it, and we were the only people there other than two German girls, I think, and it was really peaceful and serene and beautiful. So at this point, then we decided, okay, all right, let's go skinny dipping. And it was 0 degrees at that time, and we just thought it'll be fun, why not? So we find one of the pools which was a little hidden, which was a little sheltered by rocks, and then we go in, strip down to our undies, and then we jumped in, and it was freezing cold. So the minute I jumped in, it was as if like there was electricity going through my body, and it was so painful and so cold. But once I adjusted, it was a really otherworldly experience. I know it sounds crazy, but it was almost as if I was having a spiritual experience of some kind. So we finally come out and we get dressed. So we walk back to our hostel, and at this time, it started snowing. It was just the most amazing, fluffy, fresh snow. And even the locals were really, really happy because it was the first snowfall of the season. So everybody was really excited, and within just about 10 minutes, everything that was green earlier was now white, and it was the most beautiful and magical thing ever. Finally, it was time for us to go. We took our night bus back home, and that was the end of our trip. And I hope I didn't ramble too much. And if you'd like more such travel stories, I have a lot of crazy stories in my bag. So if this video was fun for you, please let me know, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.